On April 20th, 1759, Joseph I ordered the expulsion of the Jesuits from Portugal and its dominions. Pombal showed little concern for mercy or justice in this whole process, including the expulsion itself. He had the Jesuits put on ships like cattle and deported them all the way to Italy. Yet the deportees were, in a sense, the lucky ones. Many Jesuit superiors in Portugal, as well as large numbers of Jesuits from the overseas missions, were imprisoned in notorious underground dungeons, where they languished, and where many died under the appalling conditions. It is important to note that most of the direct action against the Jesuits in France came from voices within the church. Disparate though they were, and largely, but by no means exclusively, lay as opposed to clerical, especially with regard to the intersecting interests of many parlementaire, Gallicans, and Jansenists. Regarding the expulsion of the Jesuits from France, Louis XV's very mixed feelings are apparent in what he wrote. "I have no overwhelming love for the Jesuits, but every heresy has made them an object of contempt. This is to their honor. I shall say no more. If, for the peace of my kingdom, I unwillingly dismiss them, I wish at least that it not be believed that I concurred in all that the parlementaire did and said against them." Cordara estimates that a total of about 5,000 or more Jesuits were expelled from Spanish domains worldwide, whereas Hull puts the figure much higher, at about 10,000. Although the latter figure is almost certainly too high, there is no doubt that the Spanish assistancy had been by far the largest in the society, and that its demise was a devastating loss. Concerning education, 188 colleges and 31 seminaries worldwide were gravely impacted. Cordara lamented, "Who would not think that this last expulsion would completely satisfy Charles III, King of Spain? Who would not say that his anger with the Jesuits was spent? Yet, it was not. He wanted the entire society eliminated all over the world." Whatever his final rationale was, by the summer of 1773, Clement had agreed to suppress the society. The instrument of suppression, dated July 21, 1773, was a papal brief, as opposed to a papal bull. The Clementine brief, Dominus Ac Redemptor, is a fairly long document, but it only speaks in generalities on its supposedly central point. At the outset, it lauds the great value of religious orders for the Church, but also states that if they are no longer producing their desired fruits, it may be necessary to completely uproot and disperse them. Clement then announces, based on these various considerations, and because the society is no longer able to produce the very rich fruits and usefulness for which it was founded, that we abolish and suppress it. On August 7, 1814, Pope Pius VII issued the papal bull Sollicitudo Omnium Ecclesiarum, which restored the Society of Jesus for the whole earth, 41 years after its abolition. On that day, Pope Pius VII went to the Church of the Gesù to celebrate Mass at the Ignatius altar. Then, in the Sodality Chapel of the Aristocrats, he let the papal bull be read aloud. 18 cardinals and many high dignitaries were present. Also, distinguished women took part, like the Princess Mary Louisa, a niece of King Charles III of Spain, who was there with her sons. From the order, 150 surviving Jesuits were in attendance. The new society needed a general with wisdom and firmness. That was Father Johann Rutan, who, from 1829 to 1853, directed the apostolate toward the mission countries, underlined the thoroughness of the studies, and recognized the spiritual exercises as the heart of all works of the order.